Senator Councillor Delroy Williams, Mayor of Kingston, the Honourable Donna Parchment Brown, Political Ombudsman, Mr. Bindley Sangster, son of Sir Donald Sangster, Mr. Kingsley Sangster, cousin of Sir Donald Sangster, representing Mr. Anthony Falloon, son, Miss Lisa Sangster, daughter, representing His Worship, the Mayor, Councillor Derek Sangster, Mayor of Black River, and a cousin of Sir Donald Sangster, Mr. Hugh Briscoe, Vice President of Community Relations, representing Ms. Janet Foster, Chairperson, Summerfield Community Development Association, and members, Bishop Dr. Alvin Bailey, Holiness Christian Church, heads of agencies and departments, Mrs. Marjorie Layden Curtin, Acting Executive Director of the Jamaica Cultural Development Commission, Ms. Velonique Bowen, Ms. Jamaica Festival Queen, distinguished guests, students, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. And did we say boys and girls? I think we said students. Welcome to this floral tribute in honor of the Most Honorable Sir Donald Sangster. We will now have the singing of the patriotic song, Jamaica, Land of Beauty.
Jamaica, land of beauty, we promise faithfully to serve thee with our talents and bring our gifts to and wisely, and never bring thee shame. From riverside to mountain, from cane field to the sea, our hearts salute Jamaica, triumphant, proud and free. Children should, with hearts and hands united, give thanks for everything that God has given to us. Together let us sing. From riverside to mountain, from cane fields to the sea, our hearts salute Jamaica, triumphant, proud and free.
Please remain standing as we receive the opening prayer from Bishop Dr. Alvin Bailey of the Holiness Christian Church.
Hallelujah. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Oh, give thanks unto the God of gods, for his mercy endureth forever. O give thanks unto the God of heaven, for his mercy endureth forever. O great God and Creator, our Savior Jesus Christ, and the blessed Comforter, the Holy Spirit, We acknowledge your divine presence in our midst this morning. And we thank you for health. We thank you for life. We thank you for the beautiful sunshine and the privileges we enjoy of freedom in this Jamaica land we love. Oh God, we acknowledge your presence to bless us and to inspire us as you reflect on the contribution of your son, Donald, in the advancement of the well-being of humanity, in the promotion of the well-being of the people of Jamaica, and all the goodness and good things that you have inspired him to accomplish in this land we love. I pray, God, that as we reflect on his contribution to Jamaica and honor him, O God, that we will be inspired to so make our respective and individual contributions to come to Jamaica like he did, and even in exceeding abundance. God, bless us today and what we will do. Inspire us today in immeasurable ways, and be with us in our respective challenges and pursuit as we continue to remind ourselves of the contribution of these heroes, and this hero in particular. Thank you, God, as we await your blessing. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
And now a tribute in dance by Lord Dance Ministry. It's a piece entitled Our Roots. Did you notice the elasticity of the physiognomy? I'm sure you did. There was a time when I used to dance, actually. Serious business. The inaugural season of dance for the Stella Maris Dance Ensemble. The production was entitled Children of Sisyphus. Yes, indeed. That was a long time ago. Can we have another round of applause for Lord Dance Ministry? Thank you. We'd like to acknowledge our Minister of Finance and the Public Service, the Honorable Nigel Clark. We have also been joined by the Minister of Agriculture. I'm mixing them up again, eh? Minister Green. Yes, I'm just remembering now. I was in that old space. It's a different space now. Right, I understand. Thank you very much, Minister Green. And in case I would have forgot the name, the tie is a reminder. That's the reference. There you go. Thank you very much. And so now it is time. Well, the minister did say she will deal with that. So she'll take care of that right now. Please welcome the Minister of Culture, Gender, Entertainment and Sport, the Honorable Olivia Grange.
Honorable Robert Morgan, Minister without portfolio, in the office of the Prime Minister, representing the Most Honorable Andrew Holness, Prime Minister. Minister Morgan, ladies and gentlemen, is also the Member of Parliament for the constituency Sir Donald Sangster represented until his passing. That's North Central Clarendon. And so he's here wearing two hats on the occasion this morning. Mr. Julian Robinson, representing Mr. Mark Golding, Leader of the Opposition. Dr. the Honorable Nigel Clark, Minister of Finance and the Public Service. Honorable Floyd Green, Minister without portfolio in the office of the Prime Minister and the Minister responsible for NITS. Senator the Honorable Thomas Tavares Finson, President of the Senate. Honorable Alanda Terrylong, Minister of State in the Ministry of Culture, Gender, Entertainment and Sport. Members of the Diplomatic Corps, and I should acknowledge Senator Natalie Campbell Rodriguez. Mr. Robert Montague, Member of Parliament, former Minister of Government and Chairman of the Jamaica Labour Party. Commander Judy Anil, representing the Chief of Defence Staff. Is Commander here? Commander, yes. Councillor Winston Ennis, Deputy Mayor, representing His Worship the Mayor, Senator Councillor Delroy Williams, Mayor of Kingston. Honorable Donna Parchment Brown, Political Ombudsman. Mr. Binley Sangster, son of Sir Donald Sangster. And is Mr. Kingsley Sangster here, cousin? He's not here yet. Miss Lisa Sangster, daughter, representing His Worship the Mayor, Councillor Derek Sangster, Mayor of Black River and cousin of Sir Donald Sangster. Welcome, it's good seeing you here this morning. Mr. Hugh Briscoe, Vice President of Community Relations, representing Miss Janet Foster, Chairperson, Summerfield Community Development Association, and the members who are present here this morning. Heads of agencies and departments. Mrs. Marjorie Layden Curtin, Acting Executive Director of the Jamaica Cultural Development Commission. Miss Veronique Boyne, Miss Jamaica Festival Queen, and a journalist by profession. And I want to specially welcome the students from St. Teresa Preparatory, Queens High School, Halfway Tree Primary, Michael University, Torrington Early Childhood, Mona Prep, Vauxhall High School, and Greenwich Primary. And I really want you to give them a big round of applause for being here this morning. Unfortunately, we do not have chairs to accommodate all of them. But you know, in the business of doing events, when you have standing room only, you sell off. But just to say that we welcome you here, we're happy to see you. This is normally a very short function, so you won't be standing for too long. But it's great, great seeing all of you young people here. Other distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the media. And I just want to specially thank Bishop Alvin Bailey for prayers. Now, owing to the untimely death of Sir Donald Sangster on April 11, 1967, shortly after he became Jamaica's second Prime Minister, Sir Donald Burns Sangster may have been the Prime Minister to spend the shortest time in office. However, there was nothing short about the quality of the service he gave to Jamaica. On this, the 111th anniversary of the birth of the Most Honorable Sir Donald Sangster, Sir Donald Burns Sangster, we recall his steadfast 34 years of contribution to national life. An extraordinary and multifaceted patriot, he occupied offices such as the Deputy Leader of the Jamaica Labour Party, Leader of the House of Representatives, Minister of Social Welfare, Minister of Finance, Minister of External Affairs, and Minister of Defense, among others. And before he became Prime Minister on February 22nd, 1967, Sir Donald served as acting Prime Minister on two different occasions. In 1964, when Sir Alexander Bustamante was ill, and again in 1965, until the 1967 elections when the Jamaica Labour Party was re-elected. So born on this day in 1911 in the parish of St. Elizabeth, Donald Burns Sangster was molded for a life of greatness through the prestigious Monroe College, in which he boarded at age 10. And I see a nod from the Honorable Floyd Green and from the Honorable Nigel Clark. So you know what Monroe means to them. You know where they attended. So Sir Donald Sangster placed second in Jamaica in the senior Cambridge examinations in 1927. And the senior Cambridge examinations in those days was the premier examination. The same year, his father died. Subsequently, he studied law, and at the age of 26, he came first in Jamaica in the final solicitor's examinations. Ever the rounded individual, Donald Sangster was a versatile sportsman, participating enthusiastically in cricket, football, athletics, gymnastics, and boxing while attending Monroe College. A born leader and change agent, Donald Sangster later served as captain of the St. Elizabeth Parish team in the Nethersole Cricket Cup competition, as well as a member of numerous boards and committees representing the interests of farmers, Boy Scouts, educators, and sportsmen. Sir Donald Sangster entered politics at the age of 21. That it was in 1933, when he was elected to the parish council of St. Elizabeth, in the parish of St. Elizabeth. And in 1944, he was elected to the House of Representatives as a member of the Jamaica Labour Party. He then went on to become Minister of Social Welfare and Labour, and later Minister of Finance. He succeeded Sir Alexander Bustamante as Prime Minister and only had one cabinet meeting before he fell ill, less than 2 weeks later. becoming the only Prime Minister to die in office on the 11th of April after suffering a brain hemorrhage. Queen Elizabeth II knighted him on his deathbed. His sudden death and brief tenure as Prime Minister, after years of dedicated service as a minister and deputy prime minister, placed Jamaica into a period of deep mourning. He was highly respected. He was seen as a gentleman. Sir Donald Sangster was greatly admired. He was loved and respected as a leader of utmost integrity. Thousands of Jamaicans of all classes, all strata of Jamaican life, filed past his open casket at the Kingston Parish Church to pay their respects before his interment at the National Heroes Park right here, where he laid in state for several days. He laid in state at the church. Many went to view his remains, and then he was interred here in the park. In the words of national hero Norman Washington Manley, who led the party, the opposite party, the opposition, Norman Manley said of Donald Sangster, "He was regarded with esteem and respect by all. A trustworthy person who, with full power, would hold the scales evenly balanced." So Sir Donald Sangster lived a phenomenal life in service to the Jamaican people, being a gentleman to a fault and known for his serious countenance, always serious, quiet temperament, and dedicated, hardworking personality. Such was the Most Honorable Sir Donald Byrne Sangster, whose 111th birthday anniversary we commemorate today in reverence and with deep respect and love. I thank you all for taking time out today to show your respect and to say that it is important that we honor our leaders, that we remember our leaders who have made Jamaica the place it is today and who have contributed to the development, so you all can be here to share with pride Jamaica land we love. Thank you so much for coming, and God bless you all.
Thank you very much, Minister Grange. And it's now time for the laying of floral tributes. And while the floral tributes are being laid, patriotic songs will be played. We now invite our first tribute layer, the Honorable Robert Morgan, Minister without Portfolio in the Office of the Prime Minister, representing the Most Honorable Andrew Holness, Prime Minister. Minister Morgan is also the Member of Parliament for North Central Clarendon, the constituency Sir Donald held until his passing. Thank you. now, Mr. Julian Robinson, representing Mr. Mark Golding, Leader of the Opposition. Now, a tribute by the current finance minister in honor of a former finance minister, Donald Sangster, Dr. the Honorable Nigel Clark, Minister of Finance and the Public Service. Finance Minister returns to his seat. We welcome for the next tribute to be laid the Member of Parliament and Chairman of the Jamaica Labour Party, Mr. Robert Montague. Thank you, Mr. Montague. Councillor Winston Ennis, the Deputy Mayor, representing His Worship the Mayor, Senator Councillor Delroy Williams, Mayor of Kingston and St. Andrew. Councillor Ennis will now lay the next tribute. Thank you, Councillor Ennis. Mr. Bindley Sangster, son of Sir Donald Sangster, will lay the next tribute. Our next tribute layer is Senator the Honourable Thomas Tavares Finson, cousin of Sir Donald. And he's representing Mr. Anthony Falloon, son of Sir Donald Sangster. Next in line, Ms. Lisa Sangster, daughter, representing His Worship, the Mayor, Councillor Derek Sangster, Mayor of Black River and cousin of Sir Donald Sangster.
Let us give thanks and praise to the Father for guiding us through 25 years of independence.
Give thanks and praises, we are 25.
Though the road was rocky and the hills were steep, we survive. We put the faith and trust in the Father. He's keeping us alive.
So give thanks and praises. We are 25.
How good and how pleasant it is that we can live in harmony. That all races, color and creed can live in peace and
And just for clarity, Ms. Lisa Sangster is daughter of Derek Sangster, the mayor of Black River. Mr. Hugh Briscoe, Vice President of Community Relations, representing Ms. Janet Foster, who chairs the Summerfield Community Development Association, and he'll be accompanied by Ina Henry.
Believe in the black, the green.
At this time, we're going to stand and observe a moment's silence. Long may we continue to honor the life and work of the Most Honorable Sir Donald Sangster. You may be seated. We've been asked to acknowledge Vice Presidents of the G2K, Tia Ferguson and Shay Carr. We also acknowledge Anna Paolini, UNESCO representative, and Yuri Peshkov, UNESCO head of culture. Would like to, on behalf of the Ministry of Culture, Gender, Entertainment, and Sport, and the production team of the Jamaica Cultural Development Commission, the JCDC, to the following participants, we extend gratitude for their support and cooperation in making this event possible. Our tribute lairs, all our performers, Bishop Dr. Alvin Bailey for the opening prayer, members of the Jamaica Defense Force and the Jamaica Constabulary Force, the team from the Office of the Prime Minister and the Chancery and Protocol Division, the team from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Foreign Trade, members of staff from the Medicare Ambulance Service, members of staff from the National Heritage Trust, members of staff from the National Heroes Park, members of the media, Bloom Ombel Florist, all other supporting team members. Thank you for joining us in the celebration of the life and work of the Most Honorable Sir Donald Sangster. Let us now assume the appropriate posture in singing the national anthem. Once again, La Musication, the group, will lead.
Turn all loveless, O Lord, guard us with thy mighty hand. Keep us free from evil paths. Be your light through countless hours. To our leaders, great defender, grant to wisdom from above. Justice, truth, be ours forever. So be all and in all. Jamaica, 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 land we love. Teach us to is called, strengthen us now to cherish. Give us vision lest we perish. Knowledge send us, Heavenly Father, grant to wisdom from above. Justice, truth be ours for.
thank you very much. May we all have a very productive rest of the day. Thank you.